All I have to bring is to your name. Father God, we just thank you for your love. God, that you are forever wrapping us in your arms and embracing us. God, no matter which way we run, you are still there. You still call us your own, God. We just thank you for that love, that unconditional love. I see the King of Glory coming on the clouds with fire. The whole ashes, the whole ashes. Yeah. And I see the love and mercy washing over all my sins. It's people sing, the people sing. Come on. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, rising up to take their place with selfless faith, with selfless faith. Come on, sing, I see a near revival. And I see a near revival stirring as we pray and see. And we're on our knees, we're
yeah.
God, we just love on you tonight. We love on you tonight. We love on you tonight, God. You're the one that we adore. God, the one that we are living this life for. We want to walk daily and do what you want us to do. We want to walk daily and pray what you want us to pray. We want to walk daily and be the Christians and the servants that you have called us to be, God. So right now, Lord, we just surrender to you. We surrender to you right here and right now. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, Almighty God. Why don't you just raise your hands, everyone in this place, just raise your hands for a minute. This is a sign of surrendering. This is a sign of giving up. And we do that because we want God to know that we are done controlling our lives. We do this because we want God to know that we don't want to be the ones that has to deal with the outcome. We do this because we want God to know that he's got us. That we're his and he's ours. Like a baby when they go to their daddy. And they up, up, up. Because a lot of times we're so low that up is all we can go. So tonight, God, we just thank you, Daddy God, for your love, your unconditional love, your unfailing love. God, I thank you for this generation that is rising up. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. I just want to hear a big shout of hallelujah and praise to God right now. Come on, let me hear it. Woo! All right, have a seat. Have a seat. How are you guys doing today? Good. Are you excited for Revolution?
Yeah.
Shut up, dude. 14 days away. Yeah. It's going to be bomb. Cannot wait. If you don't have your permission slip, get one, but you're supposed to bring it tonight. I don't care. Do you have yours? Look at you. Chase, you're not going. We're going to miss you. They already have plans to serve at Creation Fest, which I'm super jealous. I know. It's going to be pretty stinking awesome. All right. Yeah. So Alex is going to come up here, and he's going to take offering because he's the best offering taker ever. Right? Straight up. But then we have something for you guys. We're going to show you two funny videos, and you have to guess who picked what.
Okay.
I
like
it. Exactly. Exactly.
All right. Yo.
Yo.
So, this is what? Are you getting there? Next time. Ray. Z. All right. Is that mic don't work? Okay, whatever. All right, anyway, we're going to have to take offering. So if you guys got it, wave it in the air like you can. You can give it to the dog in the air. Is it there? All right, anyway, like I said, you know, giving unto the Lord is a good thing. It's more blessed to give than it is to
receive.
Come on, you guys are starting to get it now. All right, good. So when you bring it up, you guys know that you're sowing seed. You're sowing seed. It's like the people out there that grow like vegetables and fruits and all that stuff. It's like growing your favorite thing. Like you're putting that perfect seed into what you want to grow. So you're like, man, I want to grow a job. I want to grow into a perfect leader. I want to grow into all this other stuff. You know, you're laying down seed, and it's going to be blessed. God's going to watch over it. He's going to give you way back than what you give. You give a dollar, he gives $100. Probably, who knows? I mean, when you get a job, you're probably gonna get like way more than $100. You know what I'm saying? But whatever, he blesses you way more. So let's go ahead and pray. Father, we just thank you, Lord, for tonight, God, for the offering that's to come, God, and to keep on coming, God, to raise money for the youth, Lord, and just to sow seed into your kingdom, God. So I just pray, Lord, that you would fulfill every need of every teenager that's present and not present, God, in this youth, Lord. I just pray that you would fill their needs, God, whatever it is, emotional, financially, Lord, health, God, whatever it may be, God, just pray that you would just fill that need, God, and bless them, Lord. And for those that are looking for a job, God, I just pray wisdom and favor upon them, Lord, that wherever they go, God, that you would show them where to apply, Lord, that you would also just give them favor as they walk in, God. We just thank you for it. In Jesus' mighty name, everyone says,
amen.
Amen. All right, you guys can go ahead and give it up and then watch the video.
I went to the fridge and I opened up the meat drawer. You know what the meat drawer is, right?
Yeah. What's in there?
Well, I'll tell you what was in there. You know that bacon that's like maple? Yeah, maple flavor.
The maple kind, yeah?
Yeah, so.
Yeah?
I took that out. I thought,
yeah.
I know who would like that. Me! So I ate it.
Oh! You kidding me?
Nope. Not kidding. You know, I also noticed there was some beef in there. Yeah, you know, steak, you know, juicy. Well, I ate that too. But I went back to the fridge just a few minutes ago, and I put something together really special. You're gonna love this one. I took some chicken.
Yeah.
I put some cheese on it, and I covered it with.
Covered it with what?
I covered it with cat treats.
Yeah.
Then guess what?
What?
I gave it to the cat.
Hey, Gunther, you want to go to the bay? You want to go to Brenna's? You want to go to the bay? Yeah? You want to go to the bay? 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 Do you want your mama?
Come on, man. Let's go. Come on. Come on, please. Come on. Come on, it's time to go. Come on, get on time. Come on, get on time.
Video. No, it wasn't all one. It was, the first one was the one where he goes, oh yeah? And guess what I did to it? I ate it. No! And then the second one was all the dog compilation. So who picked the first video? Who says Emily? Raise your hand. So four people? Okay. Who do you think picked the second video? Seriously, you guys don't think I'm that funny? Alright, whatever. So which one was the funniest video?
First one?
Whatever. Ah! Alright, so I picked the first video about the one when he's talking to the dog and the dog's like, covered in a beef, right? Yeah? What kind of cheese? It's good cheese. Guess what? I ate it. Oh, I love that one. It was awesome. I just recently got that showed to me at work yesterday, actually. So it was funny. I was like, oh, so she's picking a dog funny movie. I'm like, I got one on top of that. So maybe next week you guys will probably get one right. All right, so with that being said, we are going to get to the word, and Emily is going to come up here and preach the whole entire time. No, I'm just kidding. She's going to come here and preach. And then from there. So do you guys remember last week?
I'm not all at once.
Yes. Yes. Oh, wait, were you there? Yes, you were. Oh, that's right, because I was the one who chucked that one thing at you on accident. Oh, man. All right, so what do you guys remember from last week? Who can tell me? Wake up, rise up, and light up. Yes, sir. Tell me one thing you learned.
I
can hear what?
The guys lost a lot of pride.
Yeah, they really did. My man, right there.
The girls kind of whooped them. It was not even that.
Kind of?
Okay.
She said, kind of? What? That's cool.
All right, so we learned that we are the generations, like, how do we say? We are the only ones that can save the generation, right? Not as in we, as in the only ones here, but like we as in this, our church and the body of Christ. We're the only ones that can save this generation. So we changed our name. It's no longer DCC Youth. It is
the
Uprising. And what are we born to do? Wake up. Light up. Now, what are we waking up from? Do you remember? We talked about this a little bit last week. Being spiritually dead. Okay? And we talked about how our generation is just down. That if you don't accept Christ by the age of, what was it, 11? 11. If you don't have a relationship with Christ by the age of 11, you have a 4% chance of becoming a Christian. At the age of 19. That is crazy. Isn't that nuts to think? Like, imagine how many people are in your schools right now and that haven't made that relationship with God. They haven't chose that connection yet. I mean, it's 4% chance by the time they graduate. That's like really slim. Unless we can get in there and set fire to your school spiritually. Okay, we're going to talk a little bit about some things that really have to do with a great awakening that's coming, that will help us. Because a lot of you guys, how many of you guys think right now, all the people at your school, okay, you think there's no way it can save them, right? That one person that you can think of right now that's like, no, I don't even think Jesus would want them in heaven, okay? Because we all can think of someone that is really mean, whether it's to us or to someone else, right? Whether it was you were bullied by them or you saw them bullying someone else, you're like, no, God does not even want them. But that's not true. God wants them all. And so it is our purpose and our goal in life is to spread the gospel. But a lot of us don't really know how. We kind of like taking little steps, okay? And as of right now, we're not going to treat you guys like babies because you're not babies. You guys have all been here for at least 6 months. At least. Right? Except for Chase, but I know Chase's parents, and so he knows Jesus, so better get it. But we're not going to treat you guys like babies because you know God. And if you don't know God, you're still in the process of getting to know him, but you're not a baby. You're not just born. You didn't just accept Jesus, okay? So that means you should be able to talk a little bit about Jesus to other people. So tonight we're going to talk about prayer because prayer is the only thing that can cause a great awakening. When everything else is failing, when everything else is going wrong in our own lives, and no one else around can fix it, who do we go to? God. What about that time in all the movies? I mean, this is pretty much how almost all of them go. When that one person is like really bad, and they're like, oh man, you know, just pray for me. Pray for me. Like, because they know when they're at the rock bottom that God's the only one that can save them. God's the only one that can help them. Okay, so prayer has a lot of power. I want you guys to say prayer has power.
Prayer has
Prayer has
power.
Say it again.
Prayer has power.
Louder.
Prayer has power.
Good. Look at you guys. You're awake. Okay, prayer has power. How do we use that power? You guys are like Power Rangers up in here. Like, you got power. God has given us power. But if you don't choose to use it, then that's your bad. That's like all on you. God has given us the abilities, the gifts, and the talents. Whether yours is different than mine, you still have a gift. You still have a talent. You still have a way to minister to someone that I don't. And if you don't use that, then God's going to have a talking with you. He's going to be like, now listen, all these things I had put in you, why you not use them? He's got everything he has. Okay? But he's going to look at you and go, man, I know you're a Christian. I know you're saved. I'm so glad you're here. But what did you do? Were you just saved by yourself? Or did you reach your generation? Because that's hard to do. And that's the reason why our generation is so dark right now and so dead. It's because it's hard to do. But we're all strong, so we can do it. Even if you think you're weak, even if you're stuck in sin, even if there's things that you're dealing with, maybe you don't even believe in God, he can still use you because he's going to get you. All right, babe, come explain some prayer to us.
All right. I guess so.
All right. And then we're going to show you guys a video, and the video is going to kind of re-explain what Alex is going to tell you in just a minute, and it's the cutest, funniest thing I've ever seen.
Yes, indeed. All right, so I'm not going to talk too crazy much about like prayer or anything like that, but I'm going to talk for 5 minutes. So who give me 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Raise your hand. Do me a favor, walk out. I'm just kidding. Who give me 5 minutes? Raise your hand. 5, 10. Okay, 40 minutes. All right, so I got 40 minutes now to talk about prayer. All right. So anyway, you guys are like, never raise my hand again. Every time you ask that. All right, so prayer. Who in here prays? Who in here can tell me what is okay? You pray. You know what I'm saying? Pray that, everyone can say that. All right, anyway, but you pray, right? Who can tell me what prayer is? What's that? Who can tell me what prayer is? Define prayer for me. Talking to God. Anyone else want to say stuff? Yes, sir. You said talking to God. For the most part, we can all say talking to God, right? All right. So when Robert, what was that? What were you saying? Yes. Asking and listening. Okay, that's good. So when Robert Louis Stevenson was a boy, he once remarked to his mother, "Mama, you can't be good without praying." "How do you know, Robert?" she asked. "Because I've tried," he answered. This brings in mind a story about another little fellow, one who had been sent to his room because he had been bad. A short time later, he came out and said to his mother, "I've been thinking about what I did, and I said a prayer." "That's fine," she said. "If you ask God to make you good, he will help you." "Oh, I didn't ask him to help me be good. I asked him to help you put up with me." So sometimes, see, you know what I mean? Like, we pray about certain things in life, okay? Like you said, kind of like asking, right? Asking and listening. How many of you guys would say, mostly to raise your hand. Actually, you know what? Let me do this because I'm actually in that hand category. All right? How many of you guys ask God more than you listen to him? Like ask God for things more than you listen, right? We kind of just give God his job. "Yo, God, I need a car. Yo, God, I need a woman." Well, you know, "Yo, God, I need a man." I mean, not me, but you know, you're like, "Yo, God, I need some knowledge. I need help on this test, right?" "Yo, God, G, yo, what's up, G? Big man upstairs." All right, you know, you continually ask, but you don't. See, prayer sometimes is not only just asking, but it's more listening. Yeah, I love this one quote. Sorry, let me get to it. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, where is it at? Okay, that's weird. All right. Okay, anyway, I can't find the thing. So anyway, but it was one that said, I think it was by Benjamin Franklin. It said, "Work like never before, but pray as if you're gonna die tomorrow." I was like, I'm done. All right, closing. Everyone back. Okay. But it was really good. I thought, man, you know, pray as if you're gonna die tomorrow. Man, that's awesome. That's some awesome stuff right there. All right, now let me read to you something before we get into the video. So as for the power of prayer, the fact is that every great awakening, okay, and revival that's ever happened in life of humanity has been sustained or has been worked on by prayer, not programs, okay? You know how people be like, oh man, greatest revival is because Pastor Love was like, he set up this big old block party and stuff like that. Millions got saved. It's never because of a program, but it's because of prayer. It's prayer that is what gets us. Okay, so one great example of this is found in the book of Acts, chapters 1 and 2, when prior to the Great Awakening, I'm not going to really explain it right now because the video will do it, so bear with me, that took place on the day of Pentecost, just 50 days after the crucifixion of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. 120 of the disciples, in obedience to Jesus' instruction to them, went to the upper room for 10 days to seek the face of God through prayer for the promised Holy Spirit, which resulted in a great awakening. I'm just going to play this video for you.
So what did it look like when the Holy Spirit showed up?
Well, it was 10 days after Jesus left them, 50 days after Passover, on a day called Pentecost. Pastor Paul, what's Pentecost?
Like Pentateuch means five books, Pentecost means 50th. Pentecost was a Jewish holiday 50 days after Passover.
Right. So all of Jesus' followers were together, kind of hiding away to try to keep out of trouble. And suddenly, a sound like a huge wind filled the house, and then something that looked like little tongues of fire came down on each one of them.
Did they catch on fire? Did they stop dropping low?
Luke says it was like fire, not that it was fire. So no, they didn't catch on fire.
Writing some parts of the Bible was tricky because the authors were trying to describe things that no one had ever seen before. So when Mark says the Spirit came down on Jesus like a dove, or when Luke says the Spirit came down on Jesus' followers like tongues of fire, it wasn't a real dove, and their heads weren't really on fire. That's just the best way the authors could come up with to describe what people saw.
So what powers did they get? Did anyone start shooting web?
No web shooting. The first thing that happened was they all started speaking in different languages.
Well, that's pretty cool.
And it was very helpful. Because of the holiday, there were Jews in Jerusalem from all over the Roman Empire who spoke many different languages. 15 are mentioned in Acts. And suddenly, all these visitors heard Jesus' followers speaking to them in their own language.
Whoa, that must have gotten their attention.
It sure did. And once they had their attention, the Holy Spirit gave Peter the power to get up and speak an amazing message about who Jesus was. Peter proclaimed the good news, and about 3,000 people who heard Peter speak became followers of Jesus that day.
It's a pretty good video, huh? All right, Emily's going to go ahead and come up here and talk to you a little bit about the Great Awakening.
Okay, so how many of you guys like when we kind of do stupid kid videos? Because it actually breaks it down a little bit more, right? Yeah. Like, even though it's goofy, and he's like, dude, they stop dropping, bro. Like, it's so funny. But it helps us understand it more. Because Alex and I, actually, when we watched this, we learned something that we never knew. We were like, what? Because we have heard this story many, 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 many times. But we never knew that God gave those in the upper room tongues to speak that actually people heard, and it was their language. Like, how cool is that? That God was able to input and impart something into his disciples to reach all those people there. Okay, so it says that there were 120 people up there, okay? And about 15 different tribes or different people, like with different languages, okay? And God gave them the ability to speak their language without knowing their language. How cool is that? And what happened in the end? 3,000 people were saved. 3,000 people were saved. Not because of revolution, not because of summer camps, not because of revival. Like, it was because God intervened when people were praying. That's what they did. They went up to the upper room and they spent 10 days in prayer. Because they were like, hey, God, something's got to happen. Because Jesus was no longer here. So they were scared. I mean, how many of you guys, I want you to close your eyes for a second. Imagine your life, okay, and you're friends with Jesus. Like, you know who he is. You understand his teachings. Close your eyes for a second. I want you to focus. Okay? You're with Jesus. You understand his teachings. You're getting to know him. All of a sudden, he tells you, hey, I'm going to die, and something else is going to happen. The God's going to give you a Holy Spirit, will be your comforter. How many of you guys, go ahead and open your eyes, would be a little freaked out? Yeah. You'd be like, so what's going to happen? Okay, we'd be a little scared because you're so close to this person, they're about to be taken away from you, and something else is going to come comfort you that you've never known. So the Holy Spirit fell upon them, okay, which was all in one accord. The Bible says they were all in one accord. What do you think that means? What do you think that means? They were all in one accord. They all had the same mindset, yeah. What else? They're all in sync. What about they all had the same heart's cry? What about they all got along? There was no division. There was nothing that was separating them. So they're all in this room in one accord. There's a lot of things that God calls us to do, especially when it comes to a transformation. A reformation in our hearts. Number one, we got to let go and we have to forgive. That's really hard to do. Okay? You have to let go. You have to forgive. Number two, you have to trust God. You have to trust that he's got you. No matter what circumstances come up against you, you have to trust. Is that trust going to be wavered? Oh, yes. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Because you're going to go through really hard times and kind of hard times and really hard times and really kind of hard times and not so bad. Like a car accident, you're like, man, okay, my bumper got like all messed up, whatever. Then someone dies. Highs and lows, right? But in all of that, you have to be able to trust God. You have to have that in there. Number three, you got to love God. So you have to forgive God. You got to trust and you got to love, okay? So there's some things that you guys know now that you didn't know a year ago. There's some things you know now that you didn't know 2 years ago, right? But tonight we really want to focus on stretching who we are. Stretching who we are. Because right here, we're pretty comfortable, right? Pretty safe. We're at church together with people that we know. Like, we're okay. But we want you guys to think outside of yourselves tonight. Alex is going to talk to you a little bit more about some stuff just for a few minutes. Real quick. And then we're going to have you guys spread out, okay? But tonight we want to challenge who you are because you are the ones that are changing this generation. Alex and I, we can change our generation and try and impact yours, but you guys are the change makers.
Okay. Sorry, 2 seconds. Okay, so So, like what she was saying, it's up to you guys. It's okay. Just ignore that for right now. She got that on him, so don't worry about it. I want you guys to focus up here, okay? So, she said, me and her can change our generation because we're the young adults, but you guys can change your generation. I'm probably not allowed in your school. If I was to be allowed in your school, it'd probably be because of, you know, privilege from the principal or whoever, but if I just walked in, I'd probably get in so much trouble because they'd probably think I'm going to kill you guys or something like that, right? But it's up to you to change the person next to you, your fellow schoolmates or whoever. Now let me ask you in here, who has one good true friend? Raise your hand. Okay. Keep your hands up the whole time, okay? How many has two good true friends? How many has three? How about four? How about five? Maybe six? Seven? Okay. So you guys have friends, right? Now, how many of you guys, just honestly ask, how many of you guys really, really want, out of those friends that you pray for, or that you, I guess you can say have, right? How many of you guys actually want them to come to church, your church specifically, if they're not already in church? You guys want them to, right? I mean, it's totally up to you. If you guys don't want them to, then obviously you guys don't want them to. There's nothing bad about that, okay? But it's up to you, right? Now, how many of you guys actually pray for them? It's okay. It's okay if no one raises their hand. I was the same way. I was just like, you know what? And I never really thought of that. You know, just kind of like going with life, you know? You probably think, yeah, you know, like at the time, you're like, man, Lord, just help them real quick. It's just kind of like a simple thing, like, and they're going through something, please God, help them, or whatever, right? But you want to be able to change. You want to be able to pray for them because the only way that they're going to be able to come to church or have change is through prayer. That's how the Pentecost, that's how the Great Awakening happened, was through prayer. I love what this guy said, Charles Stanley. He says, when God speaks, oftentimes his voice will call for an act of courage. Okay, so I really like that because it says, when God speaks to you, oftentimes his voice will call for an act of courage on our part, your part. So if you want to have your friend come to church or see the Lord, you have to be able to pray. You have to be able to invite them. Now, how many of you guys have friends that are in church right now, out of those true friends, right? How many of you have them that are not in church? Right? Okay, for the people that are not in church, how many of you guys want to see them in church? For the most part, a majority of you guys, right? Now, let me ask you this. And be honest with me. Have you guys ever ministered to, or at least tried to invite them to church? Yeah? Is there times where it's difficult? Where it's like, okay, and when you did ask them, did they come? No, right? Some know, some yeah, and if they did, they just didn't want to come back anymore. Now, have you guys stopped asking since then? Or have you guys continued to ask? One or twice, okay? But then sometimes you're kind of like, okay, I'm probably not going to say it anymore because now they're not wanting to come. You know what I mean? And you don't want to, like, lose that friendship at the same time, but you still want to keep that good relationship. And that's a good thing. I love your honest answer. I really do. You guys are doing great. You guys are awesome. Because I was in the same situation, kind of like, I don't know what to do, you know, I don't want to ruin the relationship and blah, blah, blah. Okay, well, in order for you to bring them to church, you have to pray, okay? So you have to be able to ask God. I love what this quote says. It's the greatest gift we can give to others is our prayers. So this next part that we're going to do, I want you guys to, for those people that you raise your hand, obviously for the people here that raise your hand, of you wanting to see the people that aren't in church to come to church, obviously it has to do through prayer. But I want you guys to actually write a prayer about them and for them. Now, you can give it to them. I really don't care. Honestly, you can keep it for yourself. But I want you guys to really check your heart. Is it a selfish heart of, really don't want them to come? Or is it a heart of, man, I'm in church, I want them to come to church. It'd be awesome to have my friend right here next to me. And be like, now you know who God is. Now life's going to be so much better for you. I mean, if Bailey brought 3 of her friends, and Chinee brought 5 of her friends, and Ashley brought 20 of her friends that didn't know. I mean, I don't know. I mean, you know what I'm saying? You got your whole class saved. You're like, whoa, 20 of her friends gets to know Bailey's friends, which gets to know Cheyenne's friends, which gets to know Chase and Ricky's friends and all those stuff. And then it's like the youth group begins to grow and grow and grow. Everyone look around you real quick. How many people are in here? 6, 7? Oh, man, that's cool. We got the same mindset. I counted 6 members too, but we're good. Cheyenne's up. All right, so 6. How many of you guys are really comfortable with 6 or 7 people here? How many of you guys want to see more people in here? Right? Because, okay, if I can be completely honest with you, is that okay? Am I allowed to be honest with you guys? No. Man, you are just way too comfortable. If I can be completely honest with you, sometimes I'm like, man, I'm bored. I want more people here. You know what I mean? Like, I want to be able to have, like, this big old huge, like, Nerf war with, like, Nerf guns and stuff like that. And then I want to have, like, this dodgeball game or, like, volleyball or, like, kickball or something like that, or softball or whatever it may be, like, capture the flag. I know we can all do that, but if I can be honest, sometimes I'm like, I want more. I don't want to just have 7 people. I want to have, like, 27, 37, 47. 57. I don't know. I just want a lot of people here. I want more. But the only way that can happen is by your part of praying and acting on it. Continue to ask them. Ask God, God, can you just soften their heart so that when I do ask them, that they'll be receptive to what I say? And they'll be like, you know what? I am actually going to come to church. You know, hey, if you keep praying for them, they're going to be like, man, what's that joy you got? What's all that good stuff you got in your life? Man, you just seem like your head's always high. You're never depressed. You're never low. And they're just like, I want that. Show me how to get that. And they'll eventually come to church, whether it's this church or another church, as long as they're going to church. I would love for them to come here because it is better for us. Better for the youth group and youth will be in to grow and stuff like that. So anyway, there's paper right here, pens. I'm going to pass this out. Matter of fact, Shine, if you can come up here, grab the paper and pens for me, and if you can pass them out. I want you guys to find your own spot, okay? And I want you guys to write a prayer. Write those names that you want to see come to know God or come to church or invite with them or for even you to just say, hey, you know what? I want to lead you to the Lord. I want that to happen. You can write, Dear God, this is for Katie. This is for Katie, Samantha, Jake, and this. And then you write a prayer. Lord, you know what? I just pray. You don't have to write like 7 prayers for each and every single person. Just write a prayer in a general sense to that group. Okay? And I also love that in Isaiah, Isaiah 30:15. And oftentimes God wants us to sit before him in a quiet place. Okay? Sometimes we can sit to him in silence. Sometimes when we pray, sometimes we're quiet. And we're just like praying in our head. And sometimes we're actually praying out loud. Consider this an out loud prayer, but yet a silent prayer. Because you're writing, but you're writing it out loud. So in Isaiah 30:15 says, in quiet and confidence will be your strength. So write a prayer. Write simply who is on your heart and who you want to come. And then after you're done, as music, I'm going to get music going. I want you guys to come up here if you can and if you will. And me and Emily, if Emily gets back, I want to personally be able to pray with you and for this person or for these people. You guys, you can personally tell me their names. You don't have to. Other than that, I can just go ahead and just pray for you or with you. Or whatever it is. Yeah, can you put music on, please? Thanks. Like prayer, worship music. And I want you guys to just come up here, and we can just agree together. Because I believe prayer can change anything and everything. But all it takes is for you to pray faithfully and continuously. make sure you pray. Make sure you sincerely and wholeheartedly mean prayer. So as they play, you guys can go ahead and write your prayers out. I'll give you a couple minutes or so, and then you come on up.
Alright, just a reminder that when you guys are done, then just come on up and just stand up here and just worship, and Lord will come pray with you guys, okay?
Like I said, if you guys are ready, you guys can come up. You don't have to go one at a time. You guys can just all line up here. Come to God, just praying to Him. Come at the altar, worship me and Him. Say, God, you know what? I know that you can hear me. He doesn't turn his deaf ear. And me and Emily will just come around and we'll pray for you and so on and so forth. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, guys, we're just going to go ahead and close out. I love what, real quick, actually, matter of fact, I'm going to say something. Love what this, looked at this prayer book stuff. The one says, good morning, Lord. What are you up to today? Can I be a part of it? Thank you. Amen. Just a simple prayer. Simple prayer. What are you up to? I want to be a part of it. Something like that. When you wake up tomorrow morning, or when you go to bed tonight, you rest your head, say a prayer to God for your friend. Say a prayer to God for yourself. Whatever it is. Just like the saying is, work hard. Work hard. But pray as if you'll die tomorrow. What's that last meaningful prayer that you would never pray? What if it's, Lord, I pray my mom gets 1,000 cats. I don't know. You know, whatever it is. If that's meaningful to you, I don't know. Or maybe it's, Lord, I pray, God, that you would, if I were to leave this earth tomorrow, and my family would stay, my friends would stay, the ones that don't know you, what's your prayer? Pray as if you'll die tomorrow. What's that wholehearted prayer that you would pray? So just think on that. Father, I just thank you, Lord, for tonight, God, for the teens that are here, Lord, God, that came, God, that sincerely prayed, God, that sincerely with their heart, God, and wholeheartedly meant what they wrote down as a prayer, God, for those friends. And God, I just pray, Lord, that you would just begin to minister to your teens that are here, God, that as we agree with every single one of your teens here, God, that we begin to see life in every area, God, that we'll be able to hear praise reports, testimonies, God, and that we'll see new faces, new bodies come in here, God, that we would just be able to have a great time. But again, God, would you just give them the strength to keep on praying, to keep on believing, God, that you would give them the faith that even when they don't see it, Lord, that they know and trust in you, that you're working something out for your good, God, for your kingdom and your will. I pray that every situation that they face, God, that you would give them the words to say, God, that you would give them the boldness to stand up for their friends that don't know you, God, and help them to minister to them. God, we just thank you for it. We glorify you, we magnify you. Let us have a great week in you. Let us continue on praying as we wake up, God. We just thank you for it. In Jesus' name, everyone says, amen.